So here we are now with our second video on the planets by Gustav Holst, and it's the second of three, three altogether. When we finished the first one, I had a wee thought, which is that it's rather nice that Holst ends Venus with one instrument playing on its own, the heavenly sound of the celesta, a suitably planetary instrument. But that's by the way. So we're on now to the third movement, and this is Mercury. We've had two slow movements because Mars is really a slowish movement anyway, and so is Venus, but very different in kind, those two. Now comes a scherzo, Quicksilver, literally, with Mercury, messenger of the gods. To hear him, we're now going to cross the Atlantic to Boston and the Boston Symphony Orchestra, conducted by William Steinberg. So our planets today are international, just as the score has become, from England and the United States. Who knew in November 1918 that it would turn out like this? So without further ado, here is Mercury, the shortest of all the movements, perhaps suitably so, because Mercury, after all, is a very fleeting character. Thank you. Thus, Mercury. Jupiter is described by Holst as the bringer of jollity. The music is in two distinct parts, the first bustling and indeed jovial in places, even puckish, the second introducing what has become a very famous, broad, rather solemn tune, set later to the words I vow to thee my country, as a kind of patriotic hymn, and now a sort of international rugby anthem about the world in union. The mistake with this tune, and you find it, is to start it too slowly and not quietly enough when it eventually comes. It can sound a little pompous, and the eventual climax is diminished if the opening is not, as Holst stipulated, no louder than mezzo forte. In Bolt's recording, we're going back there now, or Steinberg later. As in Steinberg's, and indeed Carrion's, which we won't hear, both of these faults are avoided. Then, finally, Holst cleverly joins the two tunes, bucolic and majestic, together in a very splendid conclusion. There's one other thing I want to say. The two movements from the Planet Suite that are sort of most popular, I suppose, and certainly used to feature very often together without the rest of the suite, are Mars and Jupiter. Mars, I think, because of its extraordinariness, and Jupiter because, probably partly because of that tune. And the first time I heard the Planets was a long, long, long time ago, any of the Planets, when I had a little 7-inch EP of just those two movements, Mars and Jupiter. But I think that's a great pity, because this is such a well-balanced suite that you can take it, not all suites work like this, that you can take it in its entirety as a single work, even though there are seven sections, and they complement each other in a most interesting and clever way. But for now, here we have Ceridian and Jupiter.
Thank you.
bringer of jollity. Well, we've heard 4/7 of the planet suite. We still have to visit Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. Two of those three movements are truly remarkable, and the middle one is very enjoyable. But you'll find that out in the next video, if you don't know it already. Sorry, this is not switching off. Bother.